Welcome to Thomas Livestock, a leader in swine production. Thomas Livestock is based in Broken Bow, Nebraska, and is expanding as a fourth-generation family business. R.J. Thomas started the operation in 1985, not only based on industry standards at the time, but also on values he learned working on the family farm. Today, known as a leader in the industry, Thomas Livestock hosts tour groups from around the state, around the country, and from around the world.
We are known to be one of the better in the nation, and we meet a lot of interesting people. We've had people from Australia, people from Japan, people from Russia. I teased the waitress out at the restaurant about what language she needs to learn for next week. But no, and we get a lot from these people because they come here to share, they come here to learn, but they also come here to share. So you get a lot of new ideas from the groups that come in also.
Over the past 30 plus years, there's been an enormous change in how pigs are raised, and concepts made by the general public may be based on misinformation.
I think the biggest challenges facing the hog industry and a lot of the livestock sector is trying to teach the urban public about what's actually involved in making their food. There seems to be a lot of misconceptions out there about how their food comes to be, I guess. They don't necessarily understand the care and the treatment that we take and the pride that we take in our work. And so I think probably educating the public is going to be one of the biggest challenges of the future.
The company's motto, doing what's right for people and pigs, creates an atmosphere for employees to succeed and an environment for the animals to thrive. The process begins at a sow farm, which can work with up to 5,500 head of gilts and sows, which in turn can each produce up to 35 piglets per year, for a total of over 190,000 piglets from each facility. Gilts and sows are artificially fertilized, giving each animal the best chance of becoming pregnant.
Amando here in the breeding area, he is excellent in his breeding job. He's going to average between 98 and 99% fertility. The numbers we're getting are top in the nation, and just excellent workers throughout that truly try to do the very best job they can.
Once pregnancy is achieved, the gestation period for a pig is 3 months, 3 weeks, and 3 days, or 114 days. In the farrowing barn, the employees give extra care to each pig, assisting all mothers giving birth 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. At birth, every piglet is hand-toweled and assured the proper amount of colostrum milk, giving it a healthy start and the best chance for survival.
When I started my career, if you could have 10, that was wonderful. And then eventually it came to where if you could wean 10 from every sow every time she'd give birth. Interestingly, over my 30-year career, we're now looking to wean 15. And the reason we can do that is that when sows give birth, we're there 24/7 to make sure none of the pigs die during birthing. And we also have a very, I think, almost a one-of-a-kind system to make sure that the babies don't get laid on or get sick. And so our birthing skills and our survival skills in the farrowing crate are somewhat unrivaled.
These pigs will remain in the farrowing barn until they are 21 days old and have gained approximately 15 pounds. Once the pigs have developed to this stage, they are then transferred to the wean-to-finish barn.
This is a typical setup on a wean-finish building. This will be the wiener pigs coming right off of the sow, about 15 pounds at 20 to 21 days. There's an extra feeder that's put in the pen. The tube drops down to give enough inches of space for the pig to have plenty of ample space to feed. In the bottom of the big feeder, there's nipples. It's a wet, dry feeder to allow them to drink water out of the pan. And the feed is on the shelf about a foot off of the bottom there. The secondary feeder is a dry feeder that has no water in it. It's just the feed. Off to the side, there are two cup waters in each pen that allow the pigs to drink out of those. The mat set up here, this is a comfort zone. Two heat lamps set at a specific height, keeps it 95 degrees down on the mat, nice warm comfort area for them to come and lay, to stay together as they're getting used to the barn.
Many of the wean-to-finish locations are owned by local farmers and ranchers. The farmers and ranchers are able to lease the buildings to Thomas Livestock, who in turn stock, manage, and maintain each facility. The lease provides extra income for the farmer, and in addition, they are able to use the natural waste from the location to fertilize their crops, saving thousands in fertilizer costs. Thomas Livestock has developed this program over many years, and the farmers and ranchers who participate in this program continue to express respect for how the operation works.
The Thomases are great people to work with, all the way from RJ to Matt to the office personnel and the guys that, you know, oversee the pigs. It's just a very transparent relationship that is community-centered, but involves a lot of people in the process.
We've had nothing but good dealings with the Thomas family. Everything has been just exactly the way they said it was going to be, and things flow real smooth.
It takes 13 wean-to-finish sites to accommodate just one sow farm, and each one of these facilities house 6,250 pigs. It takes just over 5 months before a pig will be ready to go to market, weighing around 300 pounds. In order to get to this point, each pig will consume an average of 700 pounds of feed. Each wean-to-finish location will use over 11 million pounds of feed each year, requiring 850 acres of irrigated cropland to produce. The amount of feed used by Thomas Livestock gives the ag industry another avenue to market their grain. In order to efficiently manage and deliver the grain to each location, Thomas Livestock created their own grain mill. This mill operates 5 days a week, 24 hours a day, to deliver over 8 million bushels of grain per year.
Some of our formulas have like 23 ingredients in it, so there's a lot of ordering and a lot of buying, so that's probably one of the most challenging parts.
Technology plays a large role at Thomas Livestock. Computer systems, security systems, and monitoring systems are all available at each location.
And we have programmers that, and we build every application to meet our specific needs. And that handles, you know, all of our raw data. As far as, you know, taking care of the pigs, we've utilized technology in a lot of different ways as far as how we just monitor the barns. We have systems in place that can tell us, you know, anything about the barns as far as, you know, temperature, the fans are running, if the feed system's going, how much water we're using. And then we've got a lot of surveillance systems in place as well, you know, as you mentioned, to watch the pigs. It's been a huge boon for us because it allows our people to really utilize their time better. So, you know, you combine all of these things together and you get a very effective and efficient workflow.
The success of Thomas Livestock comes from a management philosophy that everyone plays a vital role in the process, and that everyone should be given the tools and the opportunities to succeed.
One of our sow farms will have 22 employees, and we feel like it's vital that all 22 people take part in managing the farm. It's not something that just one or two or three people should have to burden. You know, it's the whole group that has to manage the farm, and everybody has a responsibility to hold up their end. And when you do that, you can reach the success that we've been able to accomplish in the last few years, I guess.
It's all about the employees, okay? If you have good employees, you have good production. Our production is very, very good, and it's all because we try and make the people feel like this is home, that they can contribute, that they're doing something, that we appreciate their ideas, and that gives them a sense of responsibility and a sense of ownership.
They give you the best to be successful. They give you, they give you the best that you can have, the best buildings, the best equipment, best trades. Like we have like Georgetown is high tech. They want you to succeed with them, so that's awesome. I think that's really important.
I like what I do, and I like to do my best and do my 100%, and I mean, Thomas is like part of my life, I guess, and I just like consider it that way.
I feel like I'm appreciated, like I'm a part of it, you know, of the decisions of I get a knowledge in here.
Thomas Livestock started working with pigs on their farm in 1985, And now it has grown into one of the most productive operations in the world. And the future continues to look bright for the company.
I'm Hunter, and in the future, with the help of our employees, the possibilities are endless.